Their bodies do not reflect the incoming light, but rather allow it to pass straight through them. The result is a translucent skin.
For years, scientists have been breeding animals in labs, carefully selecting their mating partners so the animals are born with the best genes in the pool. As a result, over the years, a number of animal hybrids have been created. Some, even by accident. From a cat that glows in the dark to a rat with human features. Let's talk about this and more only in today's video. Top 10 creepy animal hybrids that actually exist, part 2. Starting off this countdown, we have the zebroid. This is a cross between domestic cattle and the European bison. In fact, the European bison, aka the wizened, was once threatened by extinction, but now they were making a comeback. The zebroid were first created by Leopold Walicki in 1847, but scientists didn't breed the first fertile zebroid until 1960. In fact, after World War I, a lot of people believed that the zebroid was going to replace domestic cattle because of their low susceptibility to disease and their durability. All throughout the 1950s and 60s, scientists were working on creating these creatures in labs. Over the course of 16 years, 71 zebroids were born. Experiments continued to run on these animals until the late 1980s. That's when the experiments were shut down. One of the reasons being they were unsatisfied with the results. But also, they were scared that the zebroid would crossbreed with the endangered wild wizened and then contaminate the whole gene pool. Now, there's just one herd left and it's located in a national park. Moving on to number 9, we have the human rodent hybrid. And if you guys are liking this video so far, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. But you heard me correctly. It's a human-rodent hybrid. A stem cell biologist from Tokyo has been trying to grow human cells in mice and rats and then transplant those embryos into surrogate animals. So his experiments start by injecting some cells into rat and mice embryos. But those rodents have been genetically manipulated so they can't make pancreases for themselves. His hope is that the rodents' bodies will use the human cells to then make a pancreas. Here's the thing though. While conducting the experiments, if they find that the rats are starting to develop a human-type brain, then they have to stop the experiments on them. It's part of the agreement he has with the government. They don't want a humanized animal coming into existence. Still, we can say that there are some humanized rodents out there. Moving on to number 8, we have the leopon. Lions, no tigers, but leopards, oh my. See what I did there? A leopon is a mix between a male leopard and a female lion. If you thought leopards or lions alone were scary, wait until you take a look at this bad boy. So the leopon literally looks like it's fake. It has the head of a lion, but the body of a leopard. They are beautiful, but imagine being hunted down by one of those. No thank you. In fact, they can grow to be larger than their full-grown leopard father. Also, they can last 20 years in the wild. On average, leopards live to be around 23 years old and lions only 13, so that's pretty impressive. The first reference to the leopon was made in the first century, but it wasn't until 1910 that someone saw one in real life and it was actually credible. But don't be fooled, leopards and lions aren't out there mating with each other. These animals were produced in captivity. They're very unlikely to occur naturally in the wild. In our seventh spot today, we have the Jeep. Or geep. I don't know how you pronounce it, but I'm not talking about the car here. This is a mixture between a goat and a sheep. It's pretty cute, not gonna lie. But breeding the two can be a very risky game. Very few babies are carried to term, and even fewer manage to survive birth. Those that do survive have a bunch of genetic abnormalities. But people still cross the two together, which is sad because chances are most of the time it'll have a negative outcome. Coming in at number 6, we have the hybrid lions gone wrong. This is a sad example of breeding gone wrong. In 2006, nearly 24 crossbred lions in northern India were dying after they developed a mysterious disease. The disease was a result of inbreeding and a weakened gene pool. Nearly 80 lions were affected by this. The lions being born had weak hind legs and had difficulty walking and couldn't even run. They also had failing immune systems. Now, there's a wildlife law in India which prohibits the killing of animals. So basically, they just had to wait for these lions to die a slow, painful death on their own. It's a very tragic case of breeding gone wrong. Those poor lions. We are now at our fifth and halfway mark with the see-through frog. Scientists in Japan have managed to create a frog that has see-through skin. which is really freaking creepy if you ask me. So they created this frog by crossing two kinds of recessive color mutant frogs together. They did this through artificial insemination. And the offspring ended up producing frogs with translucent skin. Now there's a lot more to it than that, but that's just the simplified way to describe it. Now they actually have a good reason for doing this. Having frogs with visible organs means you don't need to dissect them for medical research. Instead, you can just observe by looking through them. So this reduces the need for dissecting and killing innocent frogs. In our fourth spot today, we have the glow-in-the-dark cats. No, I am not making this up. It is a real thing. Basically, these glow-in-the-dark cats were created in an attempt to stop HIV/AIDS. So the virus responsible for HIV in humans is similar to the feline immunodeficiency virus, FIV. So what they did was insert a gene that produces a fluorescent protein called GFP. This is produced naturally in jellyfish, but it's what gives these kitties a green glow. Then they also inserted a gene that blocks the FIV virus into unfertilized eggs of the cat. When the cat gave birth to the kitties, if they glowed green, that meant they also had the anti-FIV gene. They hope that these experiments will one day lead to them finding a way to make humans resistant to HIV. In our third spot today, we have the infertile pink bollworm. In 2005, the pink bollworm was becoming a huge problem in cotton farming. These invasive pests lay eggs on cotton balls. Then once they hatch, the larvae eat the seeds and damage the cotton fibers. It was getting so bad that scientists came up with this really weird way to get rid of them. Basically, they created sterile pink bollworms. They did this by treating a bunch of moths with radiation. The radiation would damage their reproduction cells, but it wouldn't kill the insect. That way, when they encountered a normal pink bollworm and the two mated, bam! It would create an infertile pink bollworm. So for 4 years, 2 billion pink bollworm moths were released into Arizona's cotton fields. They literally would fly an airplane above the fields and then drop millions of these moths down onto the crops. And thankfully, it worked. Imagine if their plan didn't work, there would be billions more pink bollworms out there. It could have destroyed the crops completely. Even the scientists admitted that it was a very risky move. Coming in at number two, we have the killer bees. Did you know that killer bees were accidentally created by scientists? See, this kind of stuff scares me. Like, what else have scientists created by accident? Basically, in the 1950s, a biologist was commissioned by the Brazilian government to create a species of bees that would increase honey production. But along the way, things went wrong. The biologist himself didn't have much experience with animal breeding. In the end, bees from southern Africa and local Brazilian honeybees made it, and it produced these angry killer bees. And then, of course, thousands of these killer bees accidentally escaped. Now, they get their name because when pissed off, they have been known to chase people down for more than a quarter mile. And on top of that, their stings are very painful. So these bees were literally created in a lab by accident. And in our number one spot today, we have the rabbit man. For this one, we have a hybrid between a human and a rabbit. Again, I'm not making this up. The first successful experiment was done in 2003 in Shanghai. A team of scientists managed to fuse human cells with rabbit eggs. In the United States, scientists have been trying to do the same, but their attempts have been unsuccessful. But in Shanghai, they managed to pull this off. This experiment was done to see if it could be used to grow cells or tissues for transplant patients. But in the end, they only allowed the human rabbit to develop for a couple of days before they had to destroy it, and then just harvest it for its stem cells. Either way, they still created a human-rabbit hybrid. All right, guys, that's all for today's video. Let me know in the comments below which one of these creeped you out the most. And now, speaking of comments, I'm gonna move on to our comment shout-out portion. I'll be shouting out comments from the video, top 10 real phobias that people actually have. Skyrim Dyster 19 the Warlord commented, "Where's the fear of boat propellers? That's real." It is real. They're terrifying, honestly. I've always been afraid to like be swimming and then... I've seen Friday the 13th way too many times. I know what happens, okay? Angry Squidward commented, "Kind of weird, but I have a fear of mushrooms. I'm not sure why, but they scare me." That is kind of weird, not gonna lie. Do you mean like the mushrooms, like if you see mushrooms on pizza, you'll get scared? Or if you see them growing from the ground, you get scared? Or does it matter? Is it just all mushrooms? What about drawings of mushrooms? What about Toad from Mario Kart? He's got a little mushroom cap. Does he scare you? I'm genuinely curious. Let me know in the comments below. Jean Meters commented, I have two weird fears. They are elephants and stairs. Again, those are pretty weird. Did you have a traumatic experience with either of those? Because then I could see why. But if you kinda were just like, ah, they scare me, then I don't know. I don't know, man. Let me know in the comments below if you have a weird fear, because I want to read them all. All right, guys, that's all the comments I'm showing out for today's video. Make sure to comment something down below for a chance to be featured in my next comment. And as always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10 for more amazing videos. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I'll see you when I see you.